Become God addicted. Become God addicted. Become God addicted. Be addicted to God. If you get addicted to God, if you get addicted to God, if you could get addicted to God, people will be looking for you without any smoke. People will be looking and rushing to find you without any blonde girl in your front. People will be looking for you. They will be looking for you without any. Some people will say they cannot start church because they don't have drums. They will find you out without any drum, without even singing. When I started the church, I was just talking. I was just talking to God. And people will be glued to me. Minus 20 centigrade. People will be glued to me in cold. Make sure that you find that contact with God. So, why am I talking about this? Because this is all darkness. People are not seeing. Why are people deceived and attracted by these fake things, artificial things? Because they cannot see where the real thing is and where the fake is. Because they have found it out. You found out the way to make things appear. And people who are not in the spirit don't even know the difference. And people keep on going to these kind of churches without even knowing that is not God, that God is nowhere close. Of course, God is everywhere. God is omnipresent. We know that. But what I'm saying is that people don't even get to see that these things are fake. We have fake pastors, fake preaching, fake praise and worship, fake church, fake building, fake everything. And people are not figuring them out. That's the advantage of prayer. Prayer makes you sharp in the spirit. Prayer makes your eyes to open. Prayer makes you to understand what's going on. Prayer makes your spirit to be shaped. Prayer makes your eyes to open. Prayer, I'm not talking of prayer like when you just pray, like I'm talking of that contact with the Father, that relationship with the Father makes your eyes open. That relationship, that fellowship with the Father makes you to know what is fake and what is real. Noah couldn't have built that ark without being in the presence of God. So he went to the presence of God. God the instruction. He saw what he needed to bring. So he was not grabbing, gasping in the dark. He was not groping in the dark. He came with concrete instruction, with concrete drawing, concrete understanding. That is what personal relationship and prayer should do for us, so that we will stop wallowing in darkness, so that we will stop groping in darkness. And religion doesn't give you this. Church doesn't give you this. Only personal relationship with God.